Okay, question number 22. Sensor adaptation is crucial for A, to maintain constant sensory experiences, B, to enhance sensitivity to the environmental change, C, to avoid sensory overload, D, to promote sensory mobility. Question 23. Which of the following scenario is an example of sensory adaptation? A, quality, quickly adjusting to the darkness after turning off the lights. B, feeling a sudden jolt of pain upon touching a hot surface. C, experiencing heightened awareness of sounds in a quiet room. D, detecting a faint odor upon entering a room and reacting strongly. Question 24. Sensory adaptation helps to prevent sensory overload by A, increasing sensitivity to the stimuli, B, ignoring irrelevant stimuli, C, enhancing perception of familiar stimuli, D, amplifying the response of novel stimuli. Question number 25. Which of the following words doesn't describe perception? A, interpretation, B, sensation, C, organization, D, integration. Question number 26. Perception is best defined as A, the registration of sensory input, B, the interpretation of sensory information, C, the detection of environmental stimuli, D, the transmission of neural signals to the brain. Question 27. What term describes the process of organizing and interpreting sensory information to give it meaning? A, sensation, B, transduction, C, perception, D, adaptation. Question 28. Which of the following is not one of the six sense organs? A, observation, B, transduction, C, olfaction, D, taste. Question 29. What term describes the minimum amount of stimuli energy needed for detecting by a sensory system? A, absolute threshold, D, difference threshold, C, just noticeable difference, D, sublimational threshold. Question 30. Which one is true about perception? A, an accurate representation of the world, B, an appropriate response to sensory input, C, the organization and interpretation of sensory information, D, the transmission of neural signals to our brain. Question 31. Which of the following words best describes the process of sensory adaptation? Alternative A, increased sensitivity, B, decreased responsiveness, C, heightened awareness, D, enhanced perception. Question 32. Which term describes the reduced responsiveness of sensory receptors to unchanging stimulus over time? A, sensory fatigue, B, sensory adaptation, C, sensory acclimatization, D, sensory modulation. Question 33. Sensory adaptation is most closely associated with A, increased sensitivity to the stimuli, B, decreased sensitivity to the stimuli, enhanced perception of stimuli, D, consistent response to stimuli. Question 34. Sensory adaptation helps individuals focus on familiar stimuli, B, novel stimuli, C, invisible stimuli, D, none of the above. Question 35. What is selective perception? A. It is a process of analyzing all stimuli equally. B. It is the ability to ignore irrelevant stimuli. C. It is a tendency to perceive only information that confirms pre-existing beliefs. D. It is a process of organizing sensory information. Question 36. In-depth perception accommodation would be most useful for which of the following activity? A. Playing golf. B. Threading a needle. C. Driving a car. D. Flying a kite. Question 36. Which of the following does not define self-esteem? A. Positive or negative evaluation of your self-concept. B. An understanding of what others perceive of you. C. A component of social cognition. D. A reflection of personal worth. Question 37. Which term describes the process by which sensory information is organized, interpreted, and consciously experienced? A. Sensation. B. Perception. C. Transduction. D. Adaptation. Question 38. Which of the following is not a type of perception? Auditory perception, visual perception, tactile perception, and D. Cognitive perception. Question 39. Which characteristics of perception is an extremely diverse response to different qualities and types of stimulation? A. Selectivity. B. Adaptability. C. Discrimination. D. Plasticity. Question number 40. The principles of closure in Gestalt psychology refers to A. The tendency to perceive incomplete facets as complete. I will repeat it. The tendency to perceive incomplete figures as complete. B. The tendency to group similar elements together. C. The tendency to perceive objects as unchanging despite changes in sensory input. D. The tendency to perceive patterns as continuous. Question 41. Which of the following is true according to the Gestalt principles of similarity? A. Objects that are close together are perceived as belonging together. B. Objects that are similar in shape, size, or color are perceived as belonging together. C. Objects that move together are perceived as a single unit. D. Objects that are symmetrically arranged are perceived as belonging together. Thank you.